For Jana Kohl, her rescued dog named Baby is more than just man's best friend. Baby has become Jana's inspiration in her fight against abusive puppy mills, and her book, A Rare Breed of Love, is the story of Baby's life before and after. Jana and Baby are here with us this afternoon. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having us, Steve.
The first 9 years of this little guy's life was pretty horrible, but not just living in a puppy mill, but on really the equivalent of death row in a puppy mill.
Yeah.
Pick up the story.
These dogs are used as breeding machines. Baby was locked in a cage for 9 years and used as a breeding dog. She was bred every heat cycle, and then her puppies were sold on the internet or through pet stores. And then when they are too old to breed, they're discarded. Some of them are shot or just left to starve to death. Or it's just absolutely the cruelest, most inhumane industry imaginable.
How did you come to adopt this?
Well, you know, like a lot of people, I was going to buy a dog from the internet. I went on a search on a puppy site, and I mentioned to a friend, and she was horrified. And she said, you cannot buy a dog from the internet or from a pet store. It'll come from a puppy mill. And I wanted to see a puppy mill for myself, so I went to see a facility. And she was right. It was like a concentration camp for dogs. It was truly a house of horrors. And I decided right then and there I was not going to buy a dog from a breeder. I was going to adopt a dog. So I went on a rescue site, petfinder.com, and I found Baby. And it said she was a puppy mill survivor, and that was all I needed to know. I wanted to give a home to a dog like this. And in Baby's case, they also cut out her vocal cords. So she can't bark.
They cut her vocal cords?
They cut all the dogs'
vocal cords. Why would they do that?
Because they didn't want to hear the dogs crying and begging to be let out of their cages.
And Baby is also had to have a leg amputated.
Yes, her front leg had to be amputated after she was rescued because she suffered from severe osteoporosis, and never walking or getting any exercise for 8 years deformed her bones, made her bones thin and brittle. So this leg was amputated after she was rescued. And they also, I don't know if your camera can pick this up, but they also tattooed a number in her ear.
A tattoo?
94.
Oh, goodness.
And this was their bookkeeping method.
So, and now you've written this wonderfully illustrated book, A Rare Breed of Love. It's the story of Baby's rescue.
Yeah, it's a celebrity book also. We wanted to gather as many celebrities as we could, a very diverse group of celebrities, by the way.
It's unbelievable how many celebrities you've got in this book. There's Barack Obama.
Yeah.
I know you've got, Chicago White Sox.
We do.
Steven Tyler, Elizabeth Dole. The list, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, we have Democrats and Republicans. We've got rabbis and priests and professional athletes and teachers and writers and doctors and scientists. And it was very important to me that we get a broad coalition of people, because that's really the only way we're going to be able to do something about this horrible problem. But the number one thing people can do is to not buy from a pet store or the internet, but to adopt.
Now, there are a few reputable breeders, I'm sure, on the internet. But
you know, there are a few humane breeders that don't lock their breeding dogs in cages their whole lives and don't breed them every heat cycle. But, you know, here's the problem, Steve, is that we're euthanizing about 4 million homeless dogs a year in the shelter system.
Yeah, yeah.
So those dogs need homes first. And wouldn't it be nice to give those, find homes for those dogs first before people buy dogs?
Well, I wish you the best. And it's Dr. Jana Kohl, because you are a psychologist.
I am.
And I wish you the best.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
And good luck with Baby.
Thanks.
You can find more about Baby, Jana's mission, and her book at our website, WGNTV.com/lunchbreak.